Phone. God damn it, did I put it up there? Doesn't matter.
Okay.
So this is more a recording for the Arcade Wars competitors. Arcade Wars Rygar is the game of the month for December for Arcade Wars. That's 1UP Arcade and Galloping Ghost, and I'm not sure what the other ones are. So I'm just going to do a little tutorial that may help some people get a higher score. You know, I'm not the best in the world. That would be Shabazz Pakistani, but hopefully this helps. So just start up a game. So I'm not playing on my Rygar cab. I'm playing on Mr. FPGA because it's easier to sit down and record things. So let's start. So I'll talk a little bit. It's an 8-way joystick, obviously. People know that. And you got to shoot and a jump. If you hold up and shoot, your little disc armor weapon does a roundhouse. So one of the first things, you notice I'm jumping at all these dragons. The reason I do that is basically point gathering. Each one of those dragons is worth 1,000 points. And 1,000 points adds up quickly on level 1. It's dangerous because they fall off and they can fall directly onto you, but on the normal default sort of arcade settings, they don't usually do that on level 1. Okay, the first thing that appears here, those things there, they're screen wipers. They'll wipe everything in the screen. Don't miss them because they're worth 10,000 apiece. Okay, so obviously I'm going to jump and try and get the points for up the top. Look at this. And because I've been talking, I don't have anything. So I know where there's a few sort of hidden things underneath. I really didn't want to do this. I might kill myself here so that I can talk a bit more about it, but I'll dodge him as I go. But as you're going through the level, these pickups that appear in these medallions, like that one's worth 1,000 points, I think it is. The stars that I just picked up then, those little white stars, are the most important pickup not to miss. Every 7 of those stars, you get a 70,000 points for every 7 stars. So the blue ones are just like points. What you really want in level 1 is a lot of T. So in some of them there's a little T, and that gives you an extra 20 kind of seconds per round. And I've actually got zero, no T's in this. You see I'm on Mr. FPGA, the ghost head that comes through has got a bit of a sprite issue that needs to be fixed. You all know about the power-up, so the first power-up in the list that I've collected there, it gives me a longer length. The second power-up is more power, so I can hit multiple enemies at once. So I mean, if you can sort of steer this head as it gets faster. So you see I'm jumping over it, but if I can anticipate it, I can steer it upwards if I get my timing right. And this is what the real pros do, like Shabazz, to dodge this thing when it's going very fast. But the timing is, because the timing gets faster and faster, it's a hard thing to do. So the other thing you want to try and do, I'll probably die doing it. Okay, is to get your score. I'm holding down to the left and I get the level bonus. I'll go through that level bonus in a bit more, but basically at the end of the level, as you go past that cauldron, if you hold down to the left and your second timer, so it's 0, obviously, because I ran out of time, and the 100th digit are the same, you can get that bonus. If they're not the same, you can do that at any time, but it's easier to hit a solid target at 0 points than it is to hit a moving target that's counting down like that. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, you know, 9, 8, 7. So it's that 100th, it's the second, kind of the third digit across, which is the seconds. I think they're faster than seconds anyway. There's a stack, so there's stars. Make sure you get all the stars. Stars will give you 70,000 when you collect 70 of them. So there's going to be a stack of guys that come up here. Now, if you've got the sun shooter, fucked it up. But the sun shooter, which is the last power up on the screen, instead of when you press up and press shoot, instead of it doing the roundhouse, it does a direct up kind of angle. Like that. I'm running out of time. Time is your greatest enemy. So that time will stop the guy from coming. So here we go. So you can get 10 points. Anytime those guys stack up, if you can hit them, another timer, thank you. There's another star. Stars are really important. I'll talk about repulse bonus later, but right now, yeah, just collecting all the stars, any timers, all that kind of thing, and all your power-ups. So this power-up means that I can jump on their head and kill them, basically. Which is actually quite dangerous. Another thing that I want to point out is a lot of times people get their feet taken out. That's how they die. Like, because the crawlers, which are the ones on the ground, that are the turtles or crawlers, whatever you want to call them, those bottom ones, you can't hit them with a normal shot. And so people get their feet taken out. You've got to duck a lot. Anytime you see them on the screen, you kind of need to take your shots ducking down. What else? Okay, there's another one of those. I missed the 10 stack because I wasn't thinking, I'm talking. So I'll try and get that zero. So right now you can see my 100 digit, it's at 5. Now it's at 6. Now it's at 8. Now it's at 1. So it's too many. I need to get that to a 0 to match the second hand on my timer. Then I can exit the level and get my bonus. So 8. I know that one of these guys is worth about 200. Yep. So now it's 0. As I go past this cauldron, I'll hold down to the left. And I'll get my 10 grand bonus as I go through it because the 0 there and the 0 in the 100 digit. Hey, Sharky. Yeah, mate, I'm just doing a little video that I want to share with Arcade Wars guys. This is the game of the month, so I'm kind of doing a little bit of a tutorial on it for them. So let's talk about repulse bonus. A repulse bonus is basically what you hit. Any enemies that you hit, or those little fire pit things that come up. So I might get 70,000 here if that's my 7th star. So probably the next star or the one after. So as I'm going through and hitting these enemies, I get what's called repulse bonus. Pretty much one repulse for every single enemy that's hit. The maximum you can get in a level, the maximum you can score as a bonus at the end of the level is 64 repulse. So what I usually do during this level, because there's a special trick to this level, if you can get the full 64 repulse bonus, plus that 0 digit at the end where you get the level bonus for 10 grand, you actually guarantee the free man on the next level, on level 4. So at the end of the timer here, I know from experience that I'm probably about 40. So if I count another 20, 40, 42, 43, 54, 55, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 62, 63, okay, and I'll hit a few more. So 64, so that's my target. And I'm at 0, so I'm going to risk it and see if I got 64. So as I go through, I'm 0 on the time, 0 on the 100 digit, get my 10 grand. And if I get 64 repulse on this particular level, I only got 62. Ha! So my free man is not guaranteed at a certain spot in the next level, but it's still a good chance that it'll appear somewhere. But sometimes it just doesn't appear. Because I wasn't really counting it. Okay, so that was my 7th star that I picked up in the game. I mean, that doesn't reset when you die or anything. So every 7 stars, you get 70,000 points. Okay, there's my free man. It's not usually, when you guarantee it, it's never here, it's in another one. Okay, so there's another star, so 6 more of those, and I get another 70 grand, basically. So each one of these things that I'm hitting, that's worth one repulse. So more time, another star, that's number 2. So I don't really count or think about the stars much, I just make sure that I pick them all up, basically. And if you see a time, a T, make sure you get it, because it just makes your life easier. Make sure that death head doesn't come quickly. Another star, that's number 3. Number 4 star, so I'm getting a few here. Okay, so if you've got the leopard, you can jump on anything's head and it will kill it, right? including these big guys. If you can time it right, and you get extra points for it, 50,000 points. So I'll try and time it for you. Okay, so you can just shoot them. They jump back and forth. It's like star number 5. But you get more points if you actually jump on those big guys' heads. You get like a bonus. So again, my second timer is at 0, so I'm looking to have a 0 in my 100 digit to get my level bonus. So 5, 6, these are worth 100, 7, 8, 9, 10, there. So I run through, hold down to the left, and I get my 10 grand bonus. Haha, yeah man. So I'm not playing my cab because it's easy to stream on this device, like the Mr. FPGA. It's got HDMI out and I can just I got an Elgato that it just captures straight into. That's pretty much, the enemies change it up. Again, there's the time. So I'm at 80 seconds, so when I get it, I get another 20 sort of seconds worth, which is very valuable, I can assure you. Because you run out of time, the big death head comes, and if you're not used to it, it's hard to avoid it dying. Okay, I should get another star. I'll probably get 70,000 here. No, next star. There it is, bang, 70 grand. So every 7 stars. I know there's a lot of hidey ones of those, these sort of medallion things, these tombstones that you hit. A lot are in the air, like a lot are already in the scene, but some are hidden in special places throughout all the levels. You just have to learn where all those are. So see this little trick I'm doing? Now, because I can shoot upwards with my shield, what you can do is if you shoot upwards and you let go of it quickly, you see I'm doing a little kind of Z and I can actually, I can increase the height from going straight up to just a little bit up to a lot up. So I can sort of, I'm about to fuck up here actually because this guy's coming. He sits there for a bit and then he's going to come. Woo! This is a good lead spot too at the end of this level. So you notice the minimap down on the right hand corner there and the little box on the minimap. So that's obviously showing where I am in the level. It's just a little minimap. So I know that I can exit at any second and I'll be right. So what I'm looking for again is that 0 in the timer. But because I know these guys are worth a certain amount, it's going to actually take me a long time to get to 0. So I'm not even going to worry about it right now. And my repulse, I don't think it'll be 64, we get 60. Oops. So, this is the level where you get the empty slot in my power-ups? Oh no, it's the next level, duh. So more stars, they're all good, they're worth 100. I mean, they're worth a lot when you get 7. 70 grand every 7 stars, I keep repeating it because it's important. Okay, these things, stream blasters, they're worth 10 grand, don't miss them. Okay, this is a bit tricky. This is where I use that trick where I shoot up and forward to make sure that, because it's very dangerous jumping up here because one could hit you. So doing this little up trick is good because it's one of the secret little hidden gems. Up and forward just to get those guys that are running along the top there. Another secret hidden blaster. Time, good. Now you can leech a lot of points here because I'm that not far from the end. If I've got a lot of time left, I'll quite often cover up the faces of those tents, and what happens is it lets a whole lot more enemies out for me to kind of leech. Okay, my death head's coming now. Okay, another star. Might be 70 grand. No, not yet. So here again, I'm at 800. So my 100 digits at 9. I just got to get it to a 0 and then I can get my level bonus. You can do that. On the next level, I'll do it not at 0 because there'll still be time on the, and I've just got to try and run through at exactly the right time to match those two things. Okay, 6, 7... There we go, 0, 100 digit. Hey, mate. Why am I playing on this cab? Because it's easier to stream and record Rygar on this cab. And I was doing a tutorial for Arcade Wars that's happening right now, and Rygar's the game of the month. So I was just going to do a little tutorial thing, talk about the different aspects of the game, so help people get higher scores, basically. So in this one, one of the things you'll notice is upshoot is almost really important. These guys drop these, they poo on you with these little pellets. It's really hard to dodge, so you've just got to be really wary of it. But you see how we've got a missing power-up down the bottom there? Okay, that's dangerous because the pellets can hit you. So that missing power-up, if I get a full set of all these power-ups, I should get 70 grand there, yep. If I get a full set of those power-ups, I'll get 160,000 bonus. If I die, that bonus will, all the power-ups will reset and I'll have to get them all again, but then I can get another 660 grand if I get all of them. So time is good, need that. You notice, okay, so here it is. So this is the missing piece. It's invulnerability for like 30 seconds at this stage. I'll get 160,000 bonus. So it'll run out and become empty again. And you can't fill it and get the bonus again. You kind of have to die before you can get the bonus again. So I'm going to try and match that six. Oh, fuck, I missed it. So if I had to match the six and the second hand, which is currently eight, I would have been able to get the level bonus. Because I didn't match them, I don't get the bonus. Yep, later, mate. I'm doing a little tutorial for the Arcade Wars that's on. So you can see the timer there. I'll fuck that up. What's going on here? I don't know what's going on, but I fucked that up twice. So when that timer runs out, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, then I lose my invulnerability, and that spot goes from the list. So if I fill that up again with another shield, I do not get the 160 bonus. I actually have to die to be able to re-get that bonus, which I don't really want to do. So I will at some stage and then re-get it, which will be good, but not yet. So again, ducking down always. Whenever I see those little crawlers, I'm always going to duck down to kill them. So I could shoot this guy, or I could jump on his head and get the extra 50,000 points. I'm going to jump on his head. So again, crawlers, and these guys are ducked down for too, because they become really problematic. I'll let them get some fireballs up and you'll see how problematic they are. Like, getting past these now can be really a pain in the butt. So you gotta get them as they're emerging, otherwise they screw you. Okay, I'll try and match it here, right? So it's very hard when getting points. So six, when the six comes, I'll exit. Okay, so now I got a 6 in the 100 digit, 6 on the second hand. I get to get that level bonus if I press down to the left on my joystick like that as I go past that cauldron. Got to hold it down to the left. Yes, this isn't a scoring game, this is a explaining game. Okay, so 10 grand there, another star. We'll try and get 7 and 70,000. So these guys, if you've got the upshooter, they're really good to leech if you've got a lot of time. You can just sit here and kind of leech them, but eventually that big death head comes, so it's only really do it at the end of a level. Okay, this is going to hit me if I don't dodge it. So the good thing about the upshooter too is I can, or the sun shooter, whatever you want to call it, is I can push upwards and get him on this rope, and then he doesn't shit on me, basically. Okay, there's another star, which is good, and there's a power up there and that. So this is where I can leech, because I know the end of the level is actually just over the way, so I usually sit here and I leech a bit. I won't do it too much here, though. I don't know if there's much of time again. Gives you just that extra second. This screen, by the way, is absolutely gorgeous. Neo MS8 or MS9, I don't know. So here, I'll try and hit the target again. So zero again, so one. There we go. I got it on one. So one on the second, one on the hold down to the left, get your 10 grand bonus. Oh yeah, yeah. So these stacks. Oh, there's something I'm doing here with this joystick that I'm missing doing that. So now I've died first time. I've lost all my power-ups, so I kind of got to collect them all again. So those power-ups come about by killing things, by the repulse. Every time you hit something, even one of these things, it adds to your repulse and it adds to your kind of timer. So things get a bit harder when you lose your power-ups, obviously. Man, that's really annoying, that stack thing. Time can run out really quickly here, so I'll try and get through. I just know where these kind of hidden gems are. So all I do is I jump in the right spot at the level, and those... I just ran into the frickin' firewall because I got a short shooter. Okay, so you can see how quickly things kill you, basically. Okay, so that gives me length. I've got length. I like length. Matt likes length. So now I can shoot further, which helps a lot. And if I get the blue one as well... So I'm going to sit here, and I'm actually going to farm a few kills, because the more... Every X amount of kills... I actually don't know what it is. I think it's a bit random. But say every 20 or 30 hits of these things, of anything, it'll drop a power-up. And when it's finished, when you got all your power-ups, it'll drop a little 1,000-point shield. So I'm looking here to get another power-up before I leave. At least one. In fact, I need the sun shooter, the one that goes upwards, to guarantee something on the level after. 1,000 points for every dragon. There we go, there's the blue one, which is what I wanted. So I'm gonna farm more points until my time goes up, because I want to get... They carry over to the next level, so I could wait here and farm enemies until I get my next power up, but this death head is going to get faster and faster until I cannot avoid it, and it will kill me. It's actually really dangerous, because the little crawlers here, they really charge you now. Basically, the enemies go up a level from this point onwards, quite a bit. Okay, let's try and get our zero bonus. 600, 9, one more blue guy would do it. That'll do, 09. So now I get my level bonus. Wise panel length too, I could imagine that. What about breadth? The blue one gives you power though, right? Ah, shit. Didn't mean to die there. Okay, see how I can't just shoot upwards and kill him anymore with that sun shooter? I actually got to jump and shoot, which is more dangerous. And there's also a kind of trick in this level to get your free man on the next level, but I'm not actually going to worry about it, because I need all my power-ups anyway just to be able to get through the game. So Mr. FPGA does have some serious sprite issues. So if you see when I go up and down, the little blue guy, he comes off the ground. He's not supposed to do that. He's supposed to sync with that tunnel. So there's sprite sync issues with the Mr. FPGA version. Doesn't change gameplay, but it certainly changes, slight sync behaviors when there's a multi-sprite enemy. Okay, so here's... I've only got 20 seconds left. That's pretty Oh, shit. So that question mark, I hate doing that. You can shoot that question mark and it'll make an invulnerability shield, which probably would have been good. Just here, I kind of needed that time before the head comes. If you get the time bonus after that head comes, it's kind of pointless. It adds to you. See how it's got 200, 20 seconds? That 20 seconds is good and all. I need that. Okay. Damn it. So this level gives you an extra man. If I get 64 repulse here, no, I can't guarantee it, basically. Damn, I stuffed up. This joystick, this Sumitsu or Samurai joystick, whatever it is, it's so touchy that those stacks of guys that give you 10,000 points. So there's a star. It's actually quite dangerous to get this star, because this level starts to get a bit tricky. Oh, shit. So the free man, if I had, would have been up on this guy. Ah, it's there anyway. Okay, that's good. That's just a random factor, that. So I'll try it again here, but if I die because I fuck up the up shooter, that would be annoying. Oh, fuck. No. How about I just do it that way? Running out of time here is a classic thing that happens. There's 7 stars, obviously gives me 70,000. Time, that's what I need here. A bit of time, a bit of breathing space. So I got the star, so I should be able to jump on this guy's head and kill him. Bang. And I'm good. So if I match up those digits, 6. Ah, I didn't match. I don't get it. Matt certainly does not stick around to watch Rustan, as he calls it. He calls Rygar Rustan because, you know, he's obsessed with DK only. So level 13 is a really important scoring level. There is a 1,000,000 point bonus here you do not want to lose. If you die underneath the 1,000,000 point bonus, you will lose it. Everything on the... Whenever you die, any pickups on the screen are cleared. So when you get to this really big mountain here, you run this mountain just after this tree. Okay, so there's a couple of things. There's all these stars in the sky that you can sort of... Firstly, so I do not want to... The 1,000,000 points is right next to this, but I do not want to fuck it up, basically. Fair in a sec. I want to get a couple of them. I can't walk off this screen or the 1,000,000 points will also be... like if I walk too far away, it'll stop. So if you hear there's a cling at the top of the screen, hear that cling, cling, that's the 1,000,000 points. Okay, very common to run out of time on this fucking level. See if there's a timer in here. Yep, 2, that's good. Man, see that? See how some of the, I've got the power shooter, which should kill everything in front. But if there's a certain amount of enemies, it'll just pass through some of them and you will die. You will get hit by them. So at this point, you're trying to kind of double tap whenever you shoot to make sure that you get anything that's charging, especially these blue guys. Show you in a sec. Come on, here they go. They're sort of like double tap, double tap, double tap. If you don't, shit like that can happen. Yay! Lost all my power-ups again. I'll just try and match this. Go 5. Okay, 9, 8. Ah, missed it. My battery running low. What the fuck? Oh man, my power's coming out. That sucks. I didn't have the power on for the laptop. I could well imagine that it'd probably fuck up the frame rate too. Oh well. So now you're going to get Donkey Kong fan for a little bit until it settles down. So yeah, lost all my power-ups again, which really sucks on this level, as it does for all levels. So yeah, a lot of spamming the button now, because when things charge you, sometimes your little joystick doesn't get them all. I've got the up shooter now, so it makes killing these things a lot easier. Time is good. Oh, you idiot! Man, I'm screwing this up right royally. End of this bridge, there's a star. Time is always good. These guys will jump. If you're right against a rock like this, the enemy actually can't hit you. Oh, wow. Clip that. Famous last words. Those guys can hit you because, yeah, okay. But the guy, the blue guys that go back and forth and little other things, they don't hit you against a rock. Okay, there you go. I just fucking ate my words by saying it. Now let's try and match that. What do we got? 2. 2. There. Got it. band stopped. Bloody Donkey Kong. Noisy machine. Let's see, it's level 15. So what's good about this level? Nothing much. It's kind of like just an in-between level. Lots of snakes. Lots of hidden kind of power-up things. Power-up pickups. So with these, so I'm always ducking down because these crawlers are everywhere. You kind of, it's a bit of a trick because you got to duck down for the crawlers, but those jumpy green guys, you got to kind of stand up there. So get you. So snakes, got to watch out for them. Should be a screen blaster there. I'm running out of time because I'm talking too much. Get the hell out of here. Please be time. It's a star. I need that. I think I'm gonna about to get a I need that time. Otherwise the death head will come. Another time, excellent. Okay, so I need to get a few heads here. I mean a few snake in the hole. So once you kill the snake, it won't come out of the holes again unless you go off screen and uncover the hole. So I'm gonna go uncover the hole. I'll cover the hole up. So now that snake will return. It'll be there again. Come on, Snakey. There he is. So I'm just getting a repulse bonus because I want to get my other power up straight away in the next level. One more power up to get basically. And I should probably try and get the level bonus. There it is. Try not to hit anything. 0-0. 10 grand. So, end of level 15, 3 million is kind of on pace for a good score, but usually I've got all my men and I haven't died. So time, it gives us lots of time. So there's one more pickup I want to get, hopefully, which is the power shooter. So again, always duck it. So these guys here, they're a real pain in the ass because they lick you. When I say they lick ya, I'll show ya. Come on, shoot. Shoot me. Oh, I'm so scared. Basically, they shoot out their little arms and they go forever. You can't jump on their head, not easily. It kind of misses them and you die. Okay, so this is the other thing I was talking about. So this is a question mark. These come up randomly in the game. This is the second one to come up. I missed the first one. You only get a bit of points covering them. But as you shoot them, they change the power-ups from all these ones to the screen blaster. And the last one is the missing piece of the puzzle. So if you've got a full set, this is very good. Because you get 160,000 bonus. I mean, you don't get to have it again, but it means you can just run through the rest of the level without really caring about getting killed, basically. I still want to jump on the head of this guy because he will give me 50,000 points if I jump on his head. You can kind of farm points here. Oop. Okay, I want zero bonus at the end of this. That's too many. So now this one's gone. Okay, that's my zero, but it's going to be too dangerous at that point. Damn it. Actually, I might just screw it. I won't try and get the bonus because I don't want to die. So this next level is literally the leeching point for the whole game. There's 27 level rounds, and this is round 17. So it's kind of like, you know, just over halfway. So this round, you get lots of these stacks, and I'll probably die because I haven't been doing this well on this particular joystick. But basically, you can go up next to it. Oh, see, I fucked it again. You got to go up next to them and shoot upwards, right? Oh, there's another question mark. That's crazy. And you get 10,000 points every time you kill a stack of those. But for some reason with this joystick, it's very, very hard to do. You notice that my invulnerability ended very quickly here. Because, later in the game, it basically it gets shorter and shorter how much free sort of time you get. So these guys are a pain in the butt. But yeah, so I'll get to the end of the level and I'll show you what I do to leech this level. You literally kill off all your men on this level. Okay, that was stupid, but it doesn't matter. Let's just get to the end of the level. This joystick is actually really, really, because it's so finicky, it's very hard to get those stacks. With the up shooter, they'll be a bit easier with this. Let me get through this and then I'll... So, I'm at the end of the level. What happens if these guys just keep coming at you three at a time? You get two of these crawlers, or three of them, and then you get this stack. Then you get another stack. You run back, kind of off screen, and come back again. And this is literally how you leech points to get fucking a massive score. Because they're 10 grand a pop. And you literally kill off all your players, all your men, doing this, jumping the death head, killing off your players, and you'll score like an easy kind of like extra million or million and a half to 2 million just doing that. If you can't get to this level, see, this joystick is so, I don't know how to put it. It's really fucking, notice how they're easier to hit. I fucked that up. They're easier to hit with a shooter. It only takes two swipes instead of a whole lot like that. The up shooter actually, the sun shooters, becomes a bit of a pain in the ass because you have to get even closer to them, which can really screw you up. So yeah, you just keep on leeching these points and killing off all your men, trying to survive. But sometimes the timing is not great until you get to the end. But I'm not going to do it because I want to continue the game. Ooh, nearly died. Man, this joystick is horrible for that. It's so kind of twitchy. I think it's more meant for fighting games, these kind of joysticks, not for these kind of arcade games. It's just too twitchy. You only gotta slightly move it in a direction and it'll change. You gotta be very precise with going upwards for those. I should get a free man in one of these, guaranteed. I don't have to do anything. It's always guaranteed this level. Is it that one? No, it'll be this one. There it is. So you see these guys do the licky lick thing. I'll show you. They're a pain in the ass. So I always duck down here because there's both the crawlers, there's the guys that run at you, and there's these long licky lick things or hand things. They're hands, it's not the tongue, but it's like a long freaking frog tongue or something. So always ducking down when I shoot, unless I know there's no crawlers on the ground. Screen blaster. Duck. Give me a time, please. Didn't get one. This can be really problematic, so I'm just going to try and get through it. This last one, I always jump over the top. Boom. Hey, Petrix! I'm doing a little tutorial for Arcade Wars. It's a competition every month that goes between the Galloping Ghost Arcade in America and the 1UP Arcade here in Brisbane, Australia, and I think there's other arcades. So I just wanted to do a little tutorial kind of Rygar video showing where kind of all the points were, how you leech, how you get the extra point at the end of the level, all that kind of thing. But unfortunately doing that has really obviously killed my points. It's not really a point game, it's just a tutorial game. So this level is a pain in the ass. You often just run out of time straight away. So you really have to push through this level quite fast. And watch for those snakes coming out, man. They are so painful. Duck a lot. So 30 seconds. There's a freebie here. So if you can hit the axe as it's coming in, that's much preferable than trying to run away from it. Okay, please give me a time, because I'm running out of time. There's one. Good stuff. So I just hit him once, then hit him again. Oh, shut up. Okay, that's at zero, so I'll get my level bonus. What's that little icon? That little eye icon that you've got there? I don't know what that one is. Yeah, at the beginning of this game, I kind of was explaining how the seven, you know, every seven stars, there's a 70,000 bonus. How the time works, how to dodge death. But now I'm just kind of playing through. This is Mr. FPGA, so this isn't my arcade machine. It's just easier to stream on this than it is on the arcade machine. But the joystick is so... it's really hard to use for the 10 stacks, the 10,000 stacks, because it's just, it's so touchy. You touch it and it just like, just changes. It's crazy. Come on. Don't do this. Where's all my extra times? There's one. Now I go jump on his head, hopefully. Bung. Time. We'll exit with the six, hopefully. Yep. Six in seconds, six in 100 digits. Hold down to the left. 10 grand. Hey, Pet Lex, I got 6.1 million the other day after my second ever game in 6 months. So I'm pretty sure I'll probably go for that world record again in the next, I don't know, soon, not too long. I'll do it at 1UP Arcade or at Netherworld or somewhere. And then Martin can get it back, yeah? So now I'm just going through the motions, basically. Just completing each level, trying to get the match, which I missed. This score will be very low. It'll be like maybe 4.5 million. Because I didn't leech at all, 27. I died a lot explaining things. If I get to the end of the game, that is. So these levels are real painful. If you guys are getting up to here, you got to make sure that everything is cleared above on the water before you go. See, having that behind you is really painful. And standing up is important here, actually. If you duck down, when those blue guys come, they will kill you. Do not duck down. You can see where the vertical or the sun shooter is handy here, because I can just I think I've missed it. Don't matter. There we go. So I'll put this video out there for, link this stream for the guys on the Arcade Wars and see if they get anything out of it. It's very long to watch the whole thing, but if a couple of the guys can get like better scores because of it, then I'd be happy. I don't know what else to explain. I've kind of explained everything now. So all it is really learning the levels and going through the mechanics of what you got to do. So sometimes those guys do very fast tongues, is what it's called. So this level is really short, so you can sit here and leech till about 45 seconds or so, but I won't risk it. Okay, yeah, one of the big things with this is to try and get these flying guys straight away in the air, because if they duck you, they can be really painful. Like, try and avoid having them duck down, basically. 7. So again, I'm going to use that sort of technique of shooting upwards and then letting go of the joystick to get these guys above me rather than having to go to the level that they're on. So that's just like shoot up and then let go. You can do it low or high. Okay, this can be real painful, this bit. Let's see if I survive. There we go. Should be 70 grand or so here, I think. This? No? Still not there. Go back to the rock. This is what I was talking about. They can't hit you if you're at the rock. Some of them. Some things can, but most of them can't. Okay, there'll be a big blue guy here. Just jump on his head. Shoot him if you're too scared to jump on his head, but he gets extra bonus if you jump on the head. Can leech a lot of points here. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to wait for my level bonus and exit. I stuffed it. I was on 8 and I hit one on the head as I went through. Hopefully I'll get another one of the shields and I get 160 bonus, but it doesn't always come up. I hope it comes up, but maybe not. Here. No. Okay, so I don't think I get it now. It will not come to me. No. That's a shame. I was really hoping I'd get it. Disappointing. It just means I miss out on 160,000 points, but I can't even hit this thing today. Bonus here. Bonus at the end of this one. Missed it again. I keep missing the match between the second hand and the 100 digit. Okay, second to last level. I get a free man on this level. Okay, so with the up shooter, if I wait until those dragons are ducking down, I can just shoot straight up and get them. Nearly lost it though. Okay, there's a free man here. One of these. So it's up on that rock. Extra bonus there, extra bonus there. Okay, Under this tree, there's two extra bonus things. You gotta always make sure you hit the axe that is thrown at you. Otherwise, it'll kill you. Ah. There might be time there, but no. I'm just gonna go through. Okay, one little. Three, I got a zero. Oh, this is zero? Ah, stopped it. Not too many. Ah, I keep missing it. I won't worry about it. So this is the last level. The last level is really easy to get through. You can try and leech for points at the end of it if you're going for a big score. If you've got lots of men left, you can get stacks of 10,000 points, but I kind of tend to just run to the end. So the first thing is a 10 stack. Hopefully I don't die because I've been really mucking this up with this joystick. Okay. So the really important thing on this is to get the birds, because if you get stuck with the birds above you and these come without any power-ups, it will kill you every single time because you'll be bouncing on top of the rhinos. So make sure the birds get hit, basically. Okay, so now we're at the end. When we get to these two guys, we're literally near the end. So we can just jump on their heads. Make sure you get the birds. Okay, so I just added a credit then. So these crawlers really attack you. So I can sit here now and I can leech points. And every now and then I'll get a stack of these 10,000 points. So I could do that for the rest of my men, basically. I fucked that up. I forgot that it was coming. So now I'll show you what I mean. If you don't have, get rid of these birds. If you don't get rid of these birds, you get stuck on top of the rhinos because you can't kill them and you will die without a power up. So you gotta get rid of the birds when they come, before the rhinos come. I'll just go through now. No point. So at the end, it just runs you into there. You go stand in the middle right here. This guy cannot kill you when you're standing in the middle. Cannot kill you. You can shoot in any direction. Shoot upwards, whatever. And it will just eventually kill him. So it's kind of like, I don't know why the end boss is so easy, but you literally don't have to do anything. You just got to eventually kill him. You can literally jump on his head with the leopard and it will kill him straight away. And he's dead. That's it. Didn't even get 5 minutes. That's because I'm not going for points. So that is Rygar from front to back. So, I don't know. Come on my stream and ask me questions if you want to know more. Or catch me in the, I don't know if you're in the 1UP arcade track thing, but yeah. That's it. I will stop the stream now and send the link to the people that wanted information on Rygar. Yeah.